So we have several so-called data points or evidence, pieces of evidence that we think might suggest that Ubuntu is in fact declining, and there will usually be some people who antagonize that and say this is not true and you couldn't measure the decline of Ubuntu based on these criteria. So the criteria I used before, actually specific criteria, is the volume of news based on the Google News aggregators, because I on a daily basis I syndicate the Ubuntu news or things matching Ubuntu, and these things which actually are about the operating system, if you gather the headlines and try to group things into subjects, some wide repetition of things, you do find that by almost 50% in analogous periods this year and last year, 50% or so was the decline of the volume of Ubuntu news. That basically means there is less interest from journalists in distribution, or it might be journalism in general declining. But I'm not too sure. Google is syndicating fewer sources. It probably syndicates more sources, and I suppose it might indicate less interest in Ubuntu. The other thing is distro watch rankings, and that's a very biased thing, because people don't have to really check what Ubuntu is up to. But let me see fewer people actually exploring the distro compared to previous periods in previous years. And if you look at the 30-day average of page views, you see stuff like Ubuntu declining to third place, and that's one big point. One of the other things you do see is a certain high level of backlash against Ubuntu and distrust, and I think that's an indicator of some issues. In addition to the fact that some of the managers, the executives, in fact, left Canonical just after the release of 11.04, so that's released in April this year. And I do think they have some issues, and I think the lack of news is just indicative of the fact that they are trying to regroup in a way and get the same momentum they once enjoyed. And so that's it for this part of the video, I suppose.